Hello everyone and welcome back. So in previous couple of videos we talked about Nest.js with MongoDB, what all different things we are getting from it. So first of all, we are using Nest.js Mongoose module to access the MongoDB collections and inserting the document, updating and deleting all different kind of operations we are doing, right? So we are using Nest.js Mongoose and we are just following basic set of operations to actually access a particular Mongoose collection with the help of module. So here we are installing Nest.js Mongoose. Then in the root module, we are initializing the connection. So this particular set of lines will actually start the MongoDB connection and will create the instance of a client. Then in the feature module, we are saying Mongoose module dot for feature. Through this, we are able to access a particular schema model in the feature module, like customer module, user module, product module. There you can just do a Mongoose module.for feature. Here schema can be product schema, user schema, customer schema. Okay. Then in the services, we are injecting these models and we are able to access them using model.findbyid, update, remove through these methods. Okay. This is basic aspects we covered. And in coming set of videos, we will talk about Nest.js with MySQL, Nest.js with the Postgres with the help of another ORM, which is there for MySQL and Postgres or any other database type ORM. We can also use SQLize type ORM, but type ORM is more popular. Okay, let's look back on our example which we have done. So we have written this example customer service customer controller. So we have written these many APIs. Okay, what other things we can do is we can take care of the validations, right? For validation, we are already using this validation pipe in main.ts. We are already using the global validation pipe. So if you are writing the DTO classes for your request payloads, like we are doing it here, create customer DTO. So in the customer, email is defined and email is required. Without email, your API will break. I mean, you will get bad request. Similarly, we can also add the request validation for query parameter, route parameter, and all these things that we are doing here. One of that, like customer ID. For customer ID, we are doing DTO validation through create customer DTO, right? In create customer DTO, we are actually validating that the ID should be is Mongo ID. So that means in the request parameter, for the customer ID, it should be a Mongo collection ID only, not any UUID, not any random string. It will allow only that in that particular case. So we can start this process again. Here we are doing DTO validation. Similarly, we can also take care of the exception handlings, right? So most of the time what we do is we are returning the data from the controller. So exception handling can be done at the service layer. So here you can see we put the try catch. If we found the user, if we are able to do the find by ID and remove, then that is fine. If we get any exception, then we are throwing internal server exception. Some user defined exceptions, or you can say, explicitly I'm throwing 404 here. If user is not found, customer model dot find by ID. If customer is not there, I'm explicitly saying customer not found and setting the status code 404 for my response, because from my controller, I'm directly calling the service. So whatever the exception I'm throwing, like 404, bad request, internal server exception, all will get converted through an appropriate status code through Nest.js. If you are throwing from this method 404, not found exception, then you will get 404. Internal server exception means you will get 500. So these few things which you should take care. We talked about validations, exception handling, and the structured way of writing, we are creating these feature modules, then feature module is getting added in the main module. Here you can see app module will have a customer module. In the customer module, we have a controllers and services. The controller of customer is defined in the customer controller and services inside a customer service and the DTO in the customer DTO. And you can also have some interface which you can define, like customer interface, which is having just all these attributes, okay? Now, if you just try to run this and see what all entities, APIs we have, you can see these are the customer APIs. Customer get, put, post, delete, and customer by ID, right? Now, we can see this in the action, how it is running. Now, if you just try to see this, customers when there is a post call and it requires email, and you are just passing some random string, then what you will get? Email must be an email, right? So we have to convert this into an email, then only you'll be able to create it. Okay, now through the get you can get all the customers. Now what if I'm trying to get a single customer by ID? I'm passing random string, right? You can see customer ID should be a Mongo ID, because we have added a DTOs, data transfer object, for request payload validation, request parameter validation, request query parameter validation. All these kind of validation you can do. It is same as like Joey validation we used to do. So only the MongoDB object is allowed, and you can see the data coming back, right? Similarly, you can also try put post delete method. Delete method is also there, which is find by ID and remove. Okay, it should be customers. Okay, it is a query parameter actually. And in the query parameter, what we are passing is, if you see this delete here, I'm looking for customer ID. So the URL for this will become customer ID equal to this. Okay, you can also validate here that customer ID should be of your MongoDB ID or not. Okay, all these validations can be done. So this is all we have for the basics, Nest.js MongoDB. In the advanced, in the coming videos, we will also talk about type ORM with MySQL, and we'll learn more. Thanks everyone.